What's going on, guys? My name is Tom from Dread Labs, and today I'm going to talk a bit about inspiration. So a lot of people have been asking me, where do I get my inspiration from? And I thought it might be cool to do a video on it, because I get my inspiration from a lot of different resources. So in this video, I'm going to talk about five different resources where I got my inspiration from. So the first main resource that I think a lot of you already use is Instagram. And I basically make sure that I follow a lot of inspiring designers or inspiration accounts, such as Nikox Collection. I'm going to show you a bit about it later. So if you only use a personal account, it might be interesting to just make a new Instagram account and only follow like designers or artists or whatever that inspires you on it, so you can have just one feed with only those like interesting posts that you want to find inspiration from in your timeline. So another way to find a lot of inspiration from different artists in one go is inspiration accounts such as Nikox Collection, Album Art Archive, Acid Graphics, Digital Archive, and much more. So this is what an inspiration account looks like. Nikox shares a lot of posts made by different artists and designers to give you a bit of inspiration to do in your next work, as well as different kinds of carousel posts with guides on how to become a better entrepreneur or designer in general. So that's really handy as well. So I really recommend you checking this account out and different accounts. So if you have any suggestions on Instagram accounts that we should follow, please share them in the comments to inspire other people as well. So another really cool way to find inspiration is through archive.org. Basically, it's the internet's archive with tons of images from dating back to the 90s. And basically, you search on metadata. So for example, here I search on posts from the year 1991 with topics. The topic is floppy disk, and in this time a lot of games were on floppy disk, I presume, or at least images of these were shared on the internet. Yeah, you can get some really cool results, as you can see here. Now they tend to be almost all floppy disks, but anyway, it's just really cool to see all these different kinds of resources that used to be around the internet back in the day. And I tend to get a lot of inspiration from it. Another source that I use is Pinterest, and this is obviously one that you might have already been using as well. And that's because, of course, Pinterest is, I think, the biggest social platform revolved around inspiration. What's nice about Pinterest is that you can actually find visually similar images really easily. So let me just go to a board, or let me just search for a flyer or something, and we'll see how quickly we can actually create a board from it. So let's just start by searching for Acid Rave Flyer. All right, now, for example, let's just pin this one. So just now I only pinned this Rave Flyer that I found by searching for Rave Flyers. And what's really nice is that you can go just scroll down and then find some ideas for this board, and you get lots of visually similar images as well as things that matched up with your search query. So Rave Flyers in this case. And see how easily I now found like so many nostalgic Rave Flyers, or at least things among the same aesthetic as the one that I was looking for, in a matter of seconds. And that's why I think Pinterest is just a little bit better on doing research for design and finding inspiration and creating mood boards. So yeah, if you haven't been using it already, I really recommend saving stuff on Pinterest as well. So the fourth one that I like is creating your own mood boards in a physical space. And as a bonus, I'm going to show you how to create a mood board quickly from your Pinterest boards. So let's just do that right now. So on Pinterest, I created this quick mood board with a few Rave Flyers, and I'm going to show you an easy way how to save these images immediately. So what we're going to do is we're going to go right click and then save as, and this will save the whole web page for you. So now in your folder, you should have a HTML document, but also a folder. And if we go to the folder, let's just sort this out by type. So, and we can just delete everything here except for the images. And my profile pic is also in there, so we can just delete this. But now we end up with all of our Rave Flyers in one folder. So yeah, that's a really easy way to find these pictures and make them ready. So what I want to do right now is put these in a Word document and just print them out. And after I print them out, I just cut them out and put it on a mood board physically. And let me just show you what my mood boards look like in my home office. So yeah, guys, this is my mood board. Sorry, this is a bit of an awkward way to film this, but this is the only way I can get my mood board here and myself with the mic in the same frame. So yeah, I mainly try to do print out as much as possible. Just cut it out with either a box cutter or a knife or whatever you have laying around. And so after I cut these up, I basically check with my grandma if she has any pins laying around that I can use for this. Let me show you that right now. So as you can see right now, there are some pins here. I think these are mainly used for clothing. So I prefer using these over thumbtacks because they visually obstruct a bit, and otherwise you'll see like a whole full field of thumbtacks. So yeah, I tend to use these because they're not as visually apparent as thumbtacks. So if you don't know where to get these, I got them from my grandma, and she does a lot with making clothes. So yeah, you could go anywhere and just find them online, or either in your local like clothing editing store, like local fashion creation store. I'm not sure what it's called, but all right. So the final one is books, design books at that. So I got these from different resources. One of them is Masala Noir, and it's made by this guy called Charles de Royan, and he does like a lot of visual compilations. For example, with blank VHS tapes, radio cards, among others, just like rave flyers and video games. So, yeah, and there's also like smaller books here, also from Masala Noir, punk flyers. Then we get to like books like this, rave art, as well as Japanese graphics and the entire history of graphic design, volume 2. So these are just a few books that I have laying around, which contain tons on tons of flyers, logos, graphics, basically, where I find my inspiration from. And it's super nice to just go up on a Sunday, do nothing at all, just put like joggers on, grab a cup of tea, and just browsing through these like for the whole afternoon. And just feeling inspired, not even doing anything with it, but it's just really nice to like. It's just really nice to just like charge while looking at other people's stuff. And other than that, it's also really nice to just take a step back from your screen for a while, not browsing social media for a change, not looking at your computer screen, and just like watching at actually printed artworks. That's why I really prefer looking at physical mood boards or books over social media stuff. So yeah, guys, that's it for today. I just want to thank you for watching this video, and I hope you learned a new way to find inspiration and save it. So if you have any suggestions for a new tutorial, new video, please leave them in the comments or join us on Discord. And I want to take this special moment to thank my patrons for supporting me and making me be able to keep this Dreadlabs thing going. So if you become a patron, you get a 15% discount in the Dreadlabs webshop, as well as access to all the tutorial project files that I've been made up to until now. And these will keep updating as we post more tutorials. In addition to all of that, you also get a Discord privilege. So please consider becoming a Patreon, and thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.